Ooh. Ooh. What? Oh, yeah.
If you're new to TikTok, I'm going to show you an easy trick to make your videos look really cool. On the bottom right corner, you can use the feature that says use this sound, and that will pull in the audio from another video. Where it says timer, you're going to pull the bar to where you want your first clip to start. It says start countdown, and it's going to record your first clip of your video. From here is when I would change my outfit and get into my second look, click timer, and record again. Once you've changed your outfit a few times, you play it back, and your video is a collection of clips.
And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way.
Interior crocodile alligator. I drive a Chevrolet movie theater. Interior crocodile alligator.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Last night I told you I loved you.
Woke up, blamed it on the vodka.
When you're spending every day on your own, and here it goes, I'm just a kid.
5 tips for looking your best on video calls. Avoid having light overhead or behind you. Instead, have it facing you. Avoid a messy background. Instead, go for neutral and uncluttered. Avoid distracting patterns. Instead, wear solid colors. Avoid wearing all black or white. Instead, opt for jewel tone colors like true red or navy. Pastels also look great. To frame your face, wear a turtleneck and dress it up with simple, cool earrings that aren't noisy. How to make your loungewear look expensive. Go monochrome with black sweatpants and a black hoodie. Pull your hair back in a sleek low bun. Add layers of gold jewelry and red lipstick for a chic finishing touch. Met Anthony when I was a single mom to my 3-year-old daughter, Jaden. I wasn't looking to date then. I had just graduated college and was busy working and spending time with her. We were introduced through mutual friends at a restaurant by chance and ended up talking for hours. I told him right away I had a daughter. In my mind, I knew I wouldn't even consider dating someone who had a problem with me having a child. The next day, he texted me and asked if we could go to dinner again, this time just the two of us. We hung out once a week and talked every day. I didn't want to be gone from Jaden too much for dates and didn't want to introduce her to any man in my life unless it was serious. I introduced Jaden to Anthony 6 months after we met, and she said he looked like Prince Eric. We spent each Saturday doing fun activities together, and I can see their bond was becoming so strong as well. Anthony proposed a year and a half after we met and also gave Jaden a tiny ring asking her to be the flower girl. We were married almost 2 years later, and he promised to love and be there for both me and Jaden no matter what. And he's kept that promise. We've been married for almost 7 years, and I can't imagine my life any other way.
I'm gonna show you a homemade paste that is amazing for acne. You can either put it all over your skin and wash your face with it, or you can leave it as an overnight blemish spot treatment.
You only need 2 ingredients, baking soda and sweet almond oil. The baking soda kills acne-causing bacteria,
and the sweet almond oil helps dissolve excess oil on your skin.
My husband and I were so inspired by seeing a young Boy Scout print ear guards for medical masks. So we used the design file to start printing them from our 3D printer for my sister-in-law, who's an ER nurse. When I posted an IG story showing the prints, my DMs were flooded asking where we were selling the ear guards. We decided to send one out to every US request free of charge. So far, we've mailed out over 1,000 guards to over 65 different healthcare professionals, and we ordered another 3D printer to double our production to keep up with my DM requests for them. We're hoping the small gesture will help our healthcare workers be a bit more comfortable.
So beautiful, now look at me.
Someone were to tell me this would be my career 6.5 years ago, I never would have believed them. I was a political science major, and right out of college, I worked at a corporate desk. But now I get to travel around the world and attend amazing fashion shows from my favorite designers in New York, Milan, and Paris. It all started in 2013. I started a fashion blog about mixing high and low pieces. At the same time, I started my Instagram account, taking photos of my outfits. In 2015, I won Breakthrough Blogger of the Year, and shortly after, I quit my corporate job to pursue this full-time. With consistency of posting daily and staying true to my style, I continued to grow both platforms. Since then, I've created a capsule clothing line for Macy's, been featured in Vogue, Vanity Fair, Marie Claire, Entrepreneur, and Forbes. H&M created a collection inspired by my style, and I was named in Create and Cultivate's list for top 100 in fashion. This job allows me to create my own hours and be my own boss. And to think, if I didn't start my blog as a hobby for fun 6.5 years ago, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. I never planned to have kids or get married, but at 19, I was pregnant and devastated. I had just ended an unhealthy relationship with my ex and struggled with all of my options knowing I would be on my own. Ultimately, I decided the best choice for me was to have my daughter and be a single mom. The minute I saw her changed me forever. I wanted to always provide a good life for her and keep her safe even though our situation wasn't ideal. I didn't want to give up my dreams of being an attorney, so I went to school and worked full time. My mom watched her so I could finish my degree. After undergrad, I got a good corporate job, which allowed me to spend more time with her. I decided to hold off on law school until she was a bit older. When she was 3, I met the absolute love of my life, and we were married 3 years later. Now she's 13, and I can't imagine my life any other way. All the struggles of being a young mom paid off because we have such a close relationship, and I just love her so much.
Mondays, I be going all natural. Tuesdays, I be keeping it casual. Wednesdays, I'ma post a little hump day pic, cause I happen to be thick, thick, actual. Thursdays, I'm at the gym, getting body, feeling real, real thotty. Everybody still call me Toddy, but Friday.
Hey, shout out Benzino. Hey.
I took a white bitch and stormed the bus. That little bitch got a throat. Fuck, I like to rock, but I'm there.
I'm going to show you how to make a cloth face mask without any sewing. First, you'll need a scarf and two hair ties. Fold the scarf towards the center. Flip it over, pull the scarf through the hair ties on each end. Fold and tuck the edges into the center. Now pull the hair tie strings and you're ready to wear. How to style a white dress three ways. For a casual daytime look, add a cropped denim jacket and sneakers. For a more edgy weekend look, add combat boots and a leather jacket. And for a date night look, cinch your waist with a statement belt and pointed toe heels to elongate your legs.
I'm going to share with you a skin detox that is amazing for your skin and perfect for quarantine right now when we're all at home. For 3 days, you're not going to put anything on your face. And you're going to wash your face with only water. You're just going to pat your face down with water to wash it. On the third day, you'll apply your detox mask from chickpea flour, turmeric, and water. You guys have to try it and let me know what you think. It's honestly changed my skin.
I'm a bitch, I'm a boss, I'm a bitch and I boss, my shine like gloss, I'm a bitch, I'm a boss,